these other new sects are there. It's not good to call the name because it's not functional. And you make mention of them for teachers to equally go there for obtain themselves. And you are talking about we emptying our pockets to update our brains, which is later going to update our pocket tomorrow. But I want to say that the 1992 set can go a step further by trying to impact on these two areas of the college to be able to help the teachers. It's not all about the students. When you come, you electrify the hostels, you work on the, you paint the hostels and do projects. Let's do things that can impact positively to the teachers so that the teachers will be better as expected by everybody. Thank you so much.
That's a good one, isn't it? It's a good one. And really, what she said is true. It is not all about the student. We are not here for the students alone. Really. And we have actually seen the library. When we were here, we used to come here playing for them. I used to find that department was I love. That place made me at least improve my heart to find that department. I remember Mr. Ik, the tall man. He was our final teacher then. But I think we will go a step further to know why this place is still locked. It's still locked, and I heard government has not handed it over to the school. When my colleagues came in there once, I think 2 Sundays ago, they wanted to take stock of what we are going to do. But since it has not been handed over to the school, there is nothing we can do. Because we are looking at the talking the place.
Yes,
that's a position.
Why
is it not? Because
I know some schools
are operational. Some schools
are
operational. Yes. Most of that
schools are operational.
And
so if people can help us, make this
work
functional, it will help us.
I don't like where you are. I see. When I go to places and I see facilities are not in use, it is wrong. Then what is it there for? No, we are going to find out. Because if this place is networked, if this place is networked, and there is subscription, the internet is working.
It's free.
And you, the teachers are going in there. You do one of two things. But please, your computer knowledge must be upgraded. This is the century where everybody must know how to press the buttons. It is not the buttons of the phone they know. But if you can use your phone and do the need to, okay.
Our distinguished presenters, my colleagues, I'm listening with keen interest what people have been saying. But in this our country, they are not hearing to what the next guy is going to say. But I feel that in our country, Nigeria, because of our diversity, especially in religion, culture, and our societal development, when we are teaching in a multicultural society, we face a lot of problems. The last speaker, Mrs. Okwa, in her last statement said, a teacher must tell his student the truth. The truth here becomes relative. You are a Kano, you are a Christian, and you are teaching a class, social studies. Probably become religious. And we now say Jesus Christ is the Son of God. I'm sure one fundamentalist may rush at you. But you as a Christian you have told the truth. But to the Muslim, you are a liar. So, where is the truth? When I was a student at Ibadan, in one of our classes, we had the topic was Nigerian government and politics. The teacher was he was talking about the crisis that led to the civil war and how the civil war started and all those things. There were so many gray areas which he didn't know. And I put my hands up. I said, sir, this thing you said here, they're all wrong. They're false. He didn't allow me to talk. He called off your lips. I sat down. As he continued to talk, other people were asking questions. He could not answer those questions. Because if they allowed me to talk, I can enlighten him from the eastern part of the country. So there, truth again has come to play. So sometimes we as teachers, the truth we bear the strength, the certain topics are limited. Things on the ballot. I will not go further. Let me listen to the next speaker. Thank you.
I will say something.
Thank you so much, sir. I appreciate that your own point of view, sir. But whether we like it or not, the truth must always be said. Even in the face of death, I will still say Jesus is the Son of God. Whether I am in Kano or not, if it is God's will that I will die in that process, so be it. Yes. If everybody keeps rolling away and say, I can't say the truth because of religious diversity, then where are we going to change the situation? It will not change. We must say the truth, whether it is painful or not. That is my submission. Thank you, sir.
Sir. Just so that I add to that,
we have taken the two papers for today. The next papers come up tomorrow. Two papers as well. And yes, one of the papers is learning how to apply teaching techniques to diverse learning environments. Okay. Yes. Would take that. Okay. I'm sure a number of you would have read it before we come tomorrow to take it.
Because of that,
sometimes I do not advocate giving the papers to the participants.
Let them write questions.
But yes, let's go through it. I hope there will be enough time tomorrow. We will be able to show off a movie tomorrow that actually has a lot to do with that. Okay? The application of teaching techniques to diverse learning to diverse and multicultural
learning outcomes
environments. There's a movie that touches on that. We have the movie here. We'll be able to show us, and maybe we'll be able to discuss. Look at that for case study, so that we would know how to apply that to our own teaching techniques and to our own environment.
Questions?
What time are we starting tomorrow?
9 o'clock.
Nine.
Thank you very much. our wonderful presenters. I actually appreciate the effort of all that have impacted on us on this issue. But my question is, my question borders on the first presenter that talked on teacher classroom controversy. I know we actually encourage us to make the children express themselves by maybe throwing a question to the class and asking them to go back and make research. They come back and now make their contribution, and then we'll now come to conclusion and we will learn from there. But coming practically to what we are having right now, even in our situation now in the school, I realize that the attitude of our students towards reading is deteriorating by the day. You can personally, I do give them questions like that, or maybe just mention a topic and say, go back and read on this. When we come back for the next class, we are going to deliberate on this. But you'll be very surprised, even as a student, some that have even passed out, you'll be very surprised that when you go back for that class and you bring up the topic, that did you read through that topic and what did you learn? What can you contribute about this or that and that? They will be all blank. Meaning that they have not made any research, they have not made any effort to read. And you can even see it on the fact that at times we may be having maybe a test or exams going on. You discover that our students will take maybe the first paper, after the first paper, they're to play football, to play, they don't even go back to even review to prepare for the next paper. And that should tell us that the reading culture is dying down by the day. I begin to wonder, are these we're not like this. And look at, if you're having exams, don't go of external exams. Even external exams, you hardly see the seriousness in our students reading us, though they're preparing for this kind of exams. Talk more of them, those of them that are in, still regular students. You see that they don't even when you give them such questions, and you're making them to go back and read, they don't want to read. You see, so how do we bring them up so that they can make contribution? So that at the end of the day, you as a teacher, you be the one that gives the whole point and the whole solution to the problem we are trying to solve, so that they can also contribute and learn, you know, from them. So my question is, how do we make them come up to read so that they can also express themselves, and by so doing, whatever they learn by themselves will stay longer in them.
Okay, thank you very much. You know, the two speakers talk about humility.
Okay.
Because, you know, there are times we do some things the same way over and over and over again. We will not get different results. We will get different results. We always get the same thing. Now, when it comes to creativity is on both sides. Creativity is on the side of the student. She has said we should allow the students to open up. When the students are open, they will be able to express themselves. And on your own side as teachers, you should also be creative. What can I bring in? What can I do differently? In this environment, you should study. What can I do? There's something I get questions. I don't bring the same thing in my next class. The way I start the class today is not the same way I start the class tomorrow. Now, students want to see a different side of class. It is a different type of lecture. Sometimes
I don't come to teach that. I come to bring something different. Different from what I'm teaching. It can be for 15 minutes. For 15 minutes. You should also bring in parents where you can show them a video. There's a way you can show them a video. But you must have understood the video. And you must know what that video will impact on them. I teach her every video. Your phone can do that. Your phone. If you don't have your phone, can do it. If you have a phone that has that possibility, you can do it. I don't know why.
Okay, to add to what my colleague has just said concerning encouraging the student to have reading culture. Yes, the students of nowadays, they don't want to read. They want shortcuts. And it is very bad for them. But we can assist them. Like when I was here in Federal Ikot-Epene, I don't know if it's still attendable. We had some teachers who asked us to go and form notes. Yes, I have formed government notes before. I have formed history notes. How will I form the notes? It's by reading. I will go to the library, the little textbook I can see, and the little one my parents bought for me. I use it, I form notes, and the teacher marks it. And the teacher will be happy that you have done something. So you don't just every time teach. Give them assignments. Like now that they are borders. No phones in the school, I understand. But that is why we are saying if this place were to be working, they can go in there, use the internet, and they'll give you what you want. And it will develop their reading culture. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much for that question. Now, you said two things that I picked. Maybe I should itemize them. One, the fact that students don't want to read. And the fact that it is not easy or practicable to implement a controversial classroom or a classroom for discussion. Those are the two things I picked from your question. I'll take it one at a time. The fact that students don't want to read, yes. This, I said something about this generation of students. They are visual. They are not literal. Okay? They want to see. They don't want to read. Now, anytime I'm opportune to talk to them on reading and establishing, improving their culture of reading, I always let them know, I tell them that yes, everybody now is trying to watch. It's a generation of visual people. Unfortunately, even we teachers are visual. We have become visual to a large extent. Okay? I tell them that it is the few that read now that would lead the rest in future. Now, this is an illustration I always give. I am sure a number of us have watched there's a particular movie. Have you read the book The Day of the Jackal?
I think
yeah. Jackal. How many of us have heard about that book?
I've heard it.
You heard it?
Yeah.
How many of us have read the movie about the movie?
Yeah.
Day of the Jackal.
Yeah.
It has a movie.
It has a book.
It has a book. In fact, the movie was made from the book.
The book.
I'm trying to remember another book now, or another movie now that I was going from. Okay. Bruce, thank you, man. Half of the Yellow Sun. Thank you, man. There's another book recently, The Vow. I don't know how many of us have watched The Vow. Okay, some of us have watched The Vow. Now, The Vow has a book, has a movie, has a book. Now, if you watch the movie, it will be difficult for you to understand some things, except you read the book. In most cases, the movie is structured for entertainment rather than for information. Okay? In most cases, the movie is structured for entertainment rather than for information. But if you read the book, you get the nitty-gritty of the detail of every action and everything that the person is doing. Those are the two different things. Now, somebody will say, I have watched that in a movie. I don't need to read
the book.
The book. That's the generation we are in. They want to watch the movie. In fact, if you give them a cartoon, there's somebody I know that publishes
a child.
Yeah. Children's
cartoons.
Children's comic. He gets to schools that want to buy the comics. And the school owners are asking,
Do you have
the CD for this thing? Is it a video? Comic. Sit down with us and read. It's not voluminous. But they are asking, do you have a video of this thing? So they want the children to read it and not to watch it. A lot of times, in fact, I said I'll talk about my wife a lot of times. My wife came home one day and told me, in a school where she was the head teacher, that the school owner said they should not be writing notes on the board for students again. That they should be photocopying the notes for them to go and read. And I was like,
who gave the money?
Forget the money.
How can they write?
Not even talk about the money. Now, I know some things. If you ask me the spelling of some words, I have to put my Bible and a paper and write it down before I can spell it for you.
Yes.
Why? Because my hand has learned to write in the motor skill thing. My hand has learned to write that word faster than my brain can think of it. If I have not written that word over time, that's why you have a lot of people these days, they can't even write complete, correct sentence.
I mean, I've seen names here, I've seen.
And yes, it was parents that complained to the school owner that his children were writing too much. Their hands were paining them. That is the generation we are in. And it is up to you, teachers, and those of us that know better, to find the right. Do you understand? If we know the right thing to do, then we should be able to tell these people and find a way for them to do it right. Now, yes, students don't want to read. Now, one of the reasons is because a lot of times our books, the books they are used to, are boring. a lot of times, they are devoid of illustration. But we will need to get them to read those books.
How? By inciting their interest, their curiosity.
Mommy, why are you coming now?
If they are curious about something, they will find it even in that boring book. Am I right? They will find it. If, for instance, the class is lively, they find out that a particular teacher comes to class and they are always talking throughout the class. They will not have class over. And they are always talking, they are laughing, they are enjoying themselves. They love that class. And whatever it takes for them to be participatory in the next class, they will do. Does that make sense, sir? Does that make sense? Hello?
Hi.
Hello, ma. Does that make sense? If the class is made lively, participatory love, they will always want to be in that class. Oh, they will not sleep. In fact, they are always enjoying themselves. They are always talking. They are always laughing. They will not sleep. And they will want to be in the class because they will feel they are playing in the class. At the end of the day, they are learning. Sir, you spoke about the religious issues and all of that. Yes, that is one of the issues that would really be brought as a controversy into the class. Especially when the teacher cannot say, oh, wow. So it is the students that will teach themselves. Does that make sense?
Yes, it does.
Have I answered both your questions?
Thank you very much, Michael.
Thank you, Edith. And also thank you, our teachers, for the time you have given us today and for the time you will give us tomorrow. Tomorrow we want to assemble here by 9 a.m. so that we can go early. And even we came we started early, by now we would have gone. We still have a time again with the prefects in the afternoon. And I want to beg of us to come early tomorrow so that we can leave them. Thank you very, very much.